Hey, you crazy bunch of bananas, the 8-Bit Monkey here, and welcome back to Seed Sunday, the time of the week when I give you a brand new seed to come enjoy and have fun with. And this week's seed was lovingly submitted over on Reddit by Tyrus. So thank you so much, Tyrus, for submitting this seed and sharing it with the community. It is an amazing seed. If you do not like running around trying to find a rooftop mansion, then I kid you not, this is the perfect seed for you. So without further ado, let's just jump it in and show what seed has on offer. So as always, of course, on the top left-hand side of the screen, as well as the top right-hand side of the screen, as well as being in the video description down below. So go copy and paste seed from the video description, put in your world, enjoy this new seed for this fine, fine Sunday. And as you can see, you'll spawn in a forest. Yes, that is all you wanted, guys, wasn't it? You wanted to spawn in a forest, I heard you call for it, and there it is, the forest. You happy? You're happy? That's the end of the seed, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm only joking. Look at this right behind you. If you turn to the right of where you spawn, you will see that there is a giant, lovely roofed forest mansion. These things are freaking insanely rare to find near spawn, and Tyrus, you did an amazing job finding the seed. Seriously, absolutely amazing. This thing is huge as well. Now, of course, I will show you some of the rooms, not all the rooms. You can explore it for yourself and see what it has on offer. But if you want to get into the main entrance, you go to the left of it, right over here. And down here, you'll see that there is the entrance. There you go. So it's simple as that. You just get yourself in. Now, turning to the left to start off, you go through here. There is a chest right up there with a couple of creepers here. How you doing? How you doing, creepers? You're a little bit of a mess there. You're a little bit of a mess. And it's skelly. Inside here, we got ourselves a bunch of cool stuff. You got some name tags, you got some wheat, you got some string, you got some bones, you got some leads, you got some coal. You got some pretty good stuff. Not the greatest, I'll be honest. You got some pretty cool stuff nevertheless. Around the corner here, you have what was once a crop farm is now nothing. It looks like they despawned. Sometimes it happens. Sometimes it happens. Over here, you got yourself a lovely little area with the dining table and an evoker or illager. I never remember what you are. I never remember, but you're something scary and horrible and have an axe. Over here you have the chest room, which unfortunately has nothing in the chest. I really wish there was stuff in those chests, but unfortunately there isn't. Around the corner you got the wool room, lovely there. And you got yourself the jails, and up here is another secret, quote-unquote secret chest. If you go up and down, then up again, then down again, then up again, then down again, there's another chest with a little bit better stuff in this one. A bunch of rotten flesh, a record 13, some more rotten flesh, some pumpkin seeds, some string, and the iron armor of awesomeness. Not too shabby. And you can just break through this wall here to get back to where we started. You don't need to go up and down, really. You can just break that wall right there, and you got yourself the chest. It's as simple as that. Now, if you turn left, or right, sorry, from where you come into the mansion here, go around the corner, there is another one of these little rooms with a chest hidden behind it with another diamond armor, as well as a few bones there, some string, a lead, some rotten flesh, and some coal in case you need to light up the night or light up this area. I mean, come on, this place is usually pitch black. Right now, my brightness settings are full whack with Optifine and stuff. So, yeah, it's going to be a lot darker than you would usually expect. There's also a pumpkin and melon farm there. Around here, you got yourself a random tree with a water pool. I have no idea what this room is. It looks random and weird though. Around the back here, you got yourself the evoker, illager. You're going to correct me in the comments, I'm sure, but this guy here, the wizardy guy, made of wool, not too bad. And then over here, you got yourself another one of those tree rooms. Not many secret rooms though in this one, unfortunately. No real secret rooms that I could find. Maybe you guys can find a secret room though. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to. Upstairs, you got yourself some more rooms and some more, oh, if I get past that, some more rooms, including the amazing chicken room. We have the giant chicken. It doesn't need a butthole, this one. The cats need a butthole. The chickens don't need it, but look at that. Amazing chicken room. Love this thing. So weird and cool and random. I don't know why it's there, but it's there. And then if you go yourself back to where we started, which is over this way, and then go around this way. I think it might be the other way, actually. I might have gone the wrong way. May have gone the wrong way. Think I might have gone the wrong way. I'm just going to break through because it's a little bit quicker. Go through here, you get the top room, and in one of these rooms is this guy right here. I don't know where he started, but he's here now. He will attack you with crocodiles from the ground. That's what they are. They're totally crocodiles, okay? Spiky things from the ground. But you can get up here through these steps here, but you can find your own way to get to that. And it looks like there's a section missing. Not sure what that's all about. Anyway, guys, that is the roofed forest mansion for this week's seed. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, I'd like it, be much appreciated. It helps the channel so load. And until next Sunday, TTYL, peace out. Yeah, bye-bye. Toodles, you crazy bunch of bananas. It's a lovely seed. Hope you enjoy it. Bye, guys. And was this song to be complete without the Amplified section? The time after the chorus, when I show you what this scene looks like in Amplified, that thing that we all love, but unfortunately everyone can run. And as always, I give you a word of warning, put in the comments down below so you know you sit after the credits. You don't get anything from it, passing as a prior enjoy that you, yes, you, are one of my top bananas because you stick around to after the chorus, and I freaking love you for that, so thank you so much for being a top banana. It means the world to me, you have no idea. So this week's word is going to be... bumfire. You heard me correctly. Not bonfire. No. This word is going to be bumfire. B-U-M-F-I-R-E. Bumfire. The reason for that is if you're, you know, near a bonfire and you turn yourself around to warm your backside, sometimes you may get a little too hot and then your butt gets on fire. Or in my case, my lovely long monkey tail. Either way, bumfire is this week's word. So put the word bumfire in the comments down below. Or maybe you have a funny story with the word bumfire in it. Or maybe a funny joke with the word bumfire in it. Or maybe you want to tell me just, you know, something normal with the word bumfire in it. Whatever you want to do with the word bumfire in it, then put it in the comments down below. If you can't write bumfire for whatever reason, put the word bonfire instead. Bonfire, bumfire, both are acceptable. So you guys, that is this week's word. So just put it in the comments down below. And like I said, I know you still have the credits, you don't get anything from it, since I enjoy that you, yes you, are one of my top bananas because you stick around. So thank you so much. So this word looks like in Amplified, guys. As always, I will never check these seeds out in Amplified until I show you what they look like. And already, I can kind of tell it looks kind of okay. Kind of okay. So we look to the left like we did at the start of the video, and apart from some clouds, not really much has changed Amplified-wise. Look at that, I mean, oh, look back up. There we go. Nothing really amazing. I'm kind of disappointed, a little bit disappointed. And over this way where the roof mansion is, it's not the greatest. I mean, I've seen better. Okay, this bit here is kind of cool. We got yourself a waterfall right there. You got yourself a really nice overhang there as well. All in all, this bit here looks kind of cool. But this bit here, where the roofed forest house is, the mansion, that looks kind of crap. It looks kind of terrible. I mean, it is higher than what it was before, because like down here is your lava level, is your normal respawn level. And up there is where it spawned in. So it is higher than it usually would be, but still not as impressive as it could be. Kind of disappointed. Now, because it is bonfire night or bonfire night, I wanted to make a little something different this time. So rather than jumping from the highest point that we can find, we're actually in fact going to burn this thing to the ground. You know, like just basically that is our bonfire. A giant wooded hill, mountain, house, whatever you want to call it. Mansion, that's the actual word for it. So this week, guys, we're going to burn this down. So I'm going to put the game mode, the game rule this week. Game rule random tick speed to, let's say, 500. 500 makes a lot of sense in my opinion because they're just going to burn the place down. And then I'm also going to get rid of the clouds so we can see what actually is going on here. Much better. And then let's set this place on fire. And then we watch the place slowly burn to the ground. It's going to cause so much lag. But it's worth it, right? And remember, bananas, whatever you are doing tonight, be it bonfires, be it playing games, be sure to be safe. I don't want to hear anything in the morning about that one of you guys accidentally blew off your fingers because you held a firework in your hand, or you burnt yourself on sparklers. Remember, always wear gloves and always, always, always have adult supervision around you if you are playing with fireworks or have any fireworks near you. It's always best to let the adults do that, okay? So until next year, guys, until next bonfire night, enjoy this house burning down. Always remember the 5th of November, light up the sky with beautiful fireworks, and stay safe. That's the most important part, stay safe. Enjoy the time lapse, and be sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe if you're not a subscriber already. New seeds every Sunday.